Our hymn is on page F21.
God, come to my assistance.
Lord, make haste to help me. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come, now and forever. Amen. Hallelujah.
The Son of Man will be delivered up to be crucified. Rescue me, Lord, from evil men. From the violent, keep me safe.
From those who plan evil in their hearts and stir up strife every day.
Who sharpen their tongue like an adder, with a poison, a viper on their lips.
Lord, guard me from the hands of the wicked. From the violent, keep me safe. They plan to make me stumble.
The proud have hidden a trap, have spread out lines in a net, set snares across my path.
I have said to the Lord, you are my God. Lord, hear the cry of my appeal.
Lord, my God, my mighty help, you shield my head in the battle.
Do not grant the wicked their desire, nor let their plot succeed.
Those surrounding me lift up their heads. Let the malice of their speech overwhelm them.
Let coals of fire rain upon them. Let them be flung in the abyss, no more to rise.
Let the slanderer not endure upon the earth. Let evil hunt the violent man to death.
I know the Lord will avenge the poor, that he will do justice for the needy.
Truly the just will praise your name. The upright shall live in your presence.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come, now and forever. Amen.
The Son of Man will be delivered up to be crucified. Everyone abandoned me, but the Lord stood by me. With all my voice I cry to the Lord. With all my voice I entreat the Lord. I pour out my trouble before him.
I tell him all my distress, while my spirit pains within me. But you, O Lord, know my path.
On the way where I shall walk, they have hidden a snare to entrap me.
Look on my right and see. There is no one who takes my part.
I have no means of escape, not one who cares for my soul.
I cry to you, O Lord. I have said you are my refuge. All I have in the land of the living.
Listen then to my cry, for I am in the depths of distress.
Rescue me from those who pursue me, for they are stronger than I.
Bring my soul out of this prison, and then I shall praise your name.
Around me the just will assemble because of your goodness to me.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come, now and forever. Amen.
Everyone abandoned me, but the Lord stood by me.
If the Son makes you free, you will be free indeed. Blessed be the Lord my rock, who trains my arms for battle, who prepares my hands for war.
He is my love, my fortress. He is my stronghold, my savior.
My shield, my place of refuge. He brings peoples under my rule.
Lord, what is man that you care for him? Mortal man that you keep him in mind.
Man who is merely a breath, whose life fades like a shadow.
Lower your heavens and come down. Touch the mountains, breathe them in smoke.
Flash your lightning, sprout the foe. Shoot your arrows and put them to flight.
Reach down from heaven and save me. Draw me out from the mighty water.
From the hands of alien foes, whose mouths are filled with lies, whose hands are raised in perjury.
To you, O God, will I sing a new song. I will play on the ten-string lute.
To you who give kings their victory, who set David, your servant, free.
You set him free from the evil sword. You rescued him from alien foes.
whose mouths were filled with lies, whose hands were raised in perjury.
Let our sons then flourish like saplings, grown tall and strong from their youth.
Our daughters, graceful as columns, adorned as though for a palace.
Let our barns be filled to overflowing with crops of every kind.
Our sheep increasing by thousands, myriads of sheep in our fields, our cattle heavy with young.
No ruined wall, no exile, no sound of weeping in our streets.
Happy the people with such blessings, happy the people whose God is the Lord.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come, now and forever. Amen.
If the Son makes you free, you will be free indeed.
You alone are holy, you alone are God. Mighty and wonderful are your works, Lord God Almighty. Righteous and true are your ways, O King of the nations.
Who would dare refuse you honor or the glory to your name, O Lord?
Since you alone are holy, all nations shall come and worship in your presence. Your mighty deeds are clearly seen.
Yes, Lord God Almighty, your judgments are true and just.
There shall be no more death or mourning. The old order has passed away.
The Amen, the faithful and true witness, the source of God's creation, says this.
Let him who thirsts come forward, and him who wants it receive the gift of life-giving water.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come, now and forever. Amen.
You alone are holy, you alone are God.
From the first letter to the Corinthians. There is a certain wisdom which we express among the spiritually mature. It is not a wisdom of this age, however, nor of the rulers of this age, who are men headed for destruction. No, what we utter is God's wisdom, a mysterious, a hidden wisdom. God planned it before all ages for our glory. None of the rulers of this age knew the mystery. If they had known it, they would have never crucified the Lord of glory. Of this wisdom, it is written, eye has not seen, ear has not heard, nor has it so much as dawned on man what God has prepared for those who love him. Yet God has revealed this wisdom to us through the Spirit.
Sed qui facit voluntatem patris mei, qui in celis est, ipse interabit in regnum celorum. Alleluia. My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior.
For he has looked with favor on his lowly servant. From this day all generations will call me blessed.
The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name.
He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation.
He has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in their conceit.
He has cast down the mighty from their thrones and has lifted up the lowly.
He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty.
He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy.
The promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come, now and forever. Amen.
Non omnis qui dicit mihi Domine, Domine, interabit in regnum celorum. Sed qui facit voluntatem patris mei, qui in celis est, ipse interabit in regnum celorum. Alleluia.
Let us bless Christ, the compassionate and merciful Lord, who wipes away the tears of those who weep. Let us cry out to him in love and ask.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Lord Jesus, you console the humble. Be attentive to the tears of the poor.
Kyrie eleison.
Merciful God, hear the cries of the dying. Comfort them with your presence.
Kyrie eleison.
Make exiles aware of your providential care. May they return to their home on earth and finally enter their home in heaven.
Kyrie eleison.
Be merciful to sinners who have fallen away from your love. Reconcile them to yourself and to your church.
Kyrie eleison.
Pray for Father Nathan, for Shannon, for all our benefactors.
Joe Keesley.
those who are tempted by suicide, and those who are in depression.
Save our brothers who have died. Let them share in the fullness of redemption.
Kyrie eleison.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Let us pray. O God, who called Saint Bruno to serve you in solitude, grant through his intercession that amid the changes of this world, we may constantly look to you alone, to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God. May the divine assistance be always with us,
and also with our brothers and sisters.
Martyrology of October the 7th. Feast of Our Lady of the Rosary, proclaimed blessed by all generations in the mysteries of the Incarnation and the Redemption. The year of the Lord 336, the death of Pope St. Marcus. Bishop of Rome for only a few months, he collaborated with Constantine in organizing the Church. This was made possible thanks to a newfound peace. Elsewhere, the heavenly birth of numerous other saints, whose names are inscribed in the Book of Life.